by Sandstrom, was kicked away by Waugh.
In comes Jágr. Oh, and Waugh kicked out the right leg at the last second as Jágr tipped it out of midair.
Getting comfortable could be a description for the Avalanche through the first half of this season. Getting comfortable with a new name, new city, and with each other. Acquiring veterans Lemieux, Ozilinch, Keane, and Waugh to join all-stars Sakic and Forsberg. The Avalanche find themselves getting comfortable with winning and atop the Pacific Division. Tonight, the New York Islanders visit Big Mac as Colorado faces off with former teammate Wendell Clark. Next.
Got what they wanted. The Islanders were looking for a hard-nosed leader in the dressing room that could put the puck in the net, and that's exactly what Wendell Clark can do. He's not going to be a playmaker. He's nothing fancy about Wendell's game, but when it comes to one goal and a big moment, look for Wendell Clark to put the puck in the net. And for the Colorado Avalanche, Lemieux, they wanted a guy that could check, could score, could play with Forsberg or Sakic, could play left wing, could play right wing, had good playoff experience, and of course, winning the MVP last year. Claude Lemieux showed that he's got NHL playoff experience, but he could be a star in the playoffs.
Against the veteran Patrick Waugh.
And Tommy Salo has not had a good record here. He is looking, I'm sure, to have the big performance tonight. I'm sure that's one of the reasons why Mike Milbury decided to go with Salo in goal after Soderstrom has started 17 straight games for the New York Islanders.
And Waugh's making his third consecutive start for the Avalanche.
And every victory will take Patrick Waugh one win closer to that magic 300 number. Right now, that number stands at 294 career victories for Patrick Waugh.
So it's the Avalanche getting set to take on the New York Islanders.
Salo leaves it behind the goal, not cleared. Clem gets it, shoots one.
It was one of the Islander players. McCabe in front of the net just put his stick out. Salo going down. You know what? Salo got a piece of that, John, and that's what happened. He got his glove on. It was going wide to bounce shoulder.
Here, four on four. Hello, Lunch into the zone. That's live, and that may have hit the outside of the goalpost. Teams are back at full strength. New York to center ice. C-Mac is skated off. And here's Clem, who has the only goal. Good pass to Lemieux. Two on one. Right in, Lemieux. Rebound! And Salo made the save. Now another chance on the far side for Yale. Into Lemieux. He had that great chance. Here's Lemieux looking to center it. Good pressure here.
Seen enough of Tommy Salo to know if he's just one of those goaltenders that gives you a heart attack on every shot but ends up making the save, or if he's having a tough night. But either way, he's fighting the puck right at this time. What a great save by Patrick Waugh. Palfy is the best scorer right now for the New York Islanders, and he had the breakaway which would have tied this game up. Big save by Patrick Waugh. But Salo, I mean, twice tonight so far, one it looked like he deflected into the net. A couple of times he's had the puck. It looks like he's gone down to freeze it. Thought he had frozen it, and he misplayed it, and the puck kept going. And again,
late scratch. Salo kicks it over the glass and into the crowd.
John, you and I were talking to Mike Ricci this morning, and, you know, he is really one of the most upbeat.
That's the proof. I think we'll see them start to jump into the offense. Here's Travis Green, a drive and a save by Waugh. As Green let go, a pretty good shot there. And Waugh got the left glove out and hung on for a faceoff.
Patrick and Pierre Lacroix said, hey, this here, I mean, Patrick, this is the best thing possible. Everything's been so emotional. Just take a couple days and relax. But there is no fiercer competitor in all the game of hockey than Patrick Waugh. And there's nothing that he would like to do but show the National Hockey League they make a big mistake by not having him at the All-Star game.
1-0 here for Colorado. We have played 7 minutes of the first period. Simon flips it in. That is the Islanders rookie, Brian McCabe. Now stolen. Yell Salah save on Mike Keane from 5 feet away. And that'll give Salah some confidence as Keane had a glorious scoring chance there. 1-0 Avalanche here.
Earlier. And if Salah comes on to play a strong game, look back on that save right there. If that would have got behind Salo, he might have been in for a very shaky evening. But he made the save. The score is only 1-0. The Islanders, if they...
Here's Kamensky again. Dropped it back. And it's tipped away, and the Islanders are on it. McKinnis has some room. Right in! And Waugh got his left shoulder on the drive by Marty McKinnis. Great chance there. Will land it.
McKinnis scored the only goal of the game.
Here comes Dead Marsh again. Drops it off. Sackett. Slap shot. Missed the goal. Here's Clem. Let's it go. Salo. Just got his right toe on that. And the Islanders scoop it high to center up. He'll walk in. Right in front. Dead Marsh tipped it. But Salo made the save. And the Islanders will shovel it down the ice. Waugh plays it ahead. Wolf. Keane is trying to get to it. Now fed up the middle. Waugh. The Islanders went up the middle with a clearing attempt, and Oslunch had a pretty good chance of his own.
Now, Dead Marsh and Schneider had come together at the far end in the Avalanche zone, and this was the second part of this. Oh, he got the elbow up big time on Dead Marsh. Dead Marsh thought it was going to be shoulder to shoulder. Watch the elbow right there. Boom. Right into the side of Dead Marsh's coconut.
Now that could be a major. No question about it, that could be a major.
That could have been a five-minute call. But, you know, it was one of those plays that...
of the tough variety.
And for a goaltender, whenever you talk to them, they always tell you that games when you get four or five shots, but a couple are tough, those are the ones when the focus has to be so strong. You have to stay in the game, talk to yourself to stay involved. All right, our first period
of Lemieux is after it, and Salo had it poking behind his goal. Lemieux nearly stole it.
Dominic Hasek, when he played for the Chicago Blackhawks, used to drive the coaches nuts because he's always been so dangerous.
Here's a pass, Simon. On the breakaway, right in! Salo makes save! And he holds on as Simon out of the box had a clear-cut breakaway, and Salo was right there.
This is a big-time save. Simon does a good job of coming out, two hands on his stick. He gets a pass, perfect breakaway. The only player behind was Forsberg. Simon walks in, and again, John, you can look at certain saves and key moments in the hockey game. And this one right here for Tommy Salo, maybe this really settles him down. He made a nice save on Keane in the first period. A watch-the play by Forsberg. Didn't know it's watch to kick the puck. Starts off every pregame warm-up before he goes in this playing soccer in the dressing room. Used it right there.
And he played soccer as a kid in Sweden and tried to kick that in. Well, flips it around. Looks for some help. Lemieux, the drive. Rebound, Kamensky. Oh, what a save by Salo. On the rebound, and he made the save and held on.
John, we've seen this a few times this year. When Kamensky's skating like this, he's almost unstoppable.
The Islander goal.
And it just tipped off the stick. You see Waugh leaning left, and all of a sudden he left enough out there to just be able to poke it into the stands.
you know, something about Patrick Liel, Young, and Denmark. Denmark has it. Good pass. Over to Lefebvre. Blast! That Salo made the save. Rebound not cleared. Lefebvre again. Into the corner. Liel back on the line. Liel has it again. Now for Young. Right in front of Denmark. Pass never got through. And the Islanders get it. Can't clear it again. Now Lefebvre fires it. Rebound. Liel. Right in. Can't pull the trigger on his backhand. Oh, what a chance there. Now Lefebvre. 15 seconds left in the power play. Sackett feeds it in front. Now back for Lefebvre again. Takes it. Now lets it go. Salvo save. And he hangs on, and another penalty has been called. A cross-checking minor, I believe, against New York.
Bouncing open. This is a big group. They don't have that big stud to stand in the middle.
Well, now back to live action. Simon. Handler back to Snyder. Bounced over his stick. And it goes down the ice. Cleared ahead. Sleep pass. Into Palfrey. Breakaway. Yeah! Unbelievable save again on Palfrey. His second breakaway of the night.
The crash Salo. He got the puck up quickly. Avalanche got caught in the line change.
Here's Palfrey now, over for Green. 1:45 to go in the major. In deep now for Clark. Here's Clark. Look to center. He does. Right in front of the chance. Fires it. And that went wide.
Really don't notice. And then all of a sudden, he'll pop out of the corner. He'll take a quick shot. He'll lay a big hit. He's one of those guys that has dramatic moments of impact in a hockey game. You may not notice them all the time. But after the game is over, he'll have done something somewhere to have an impact on the game.
Didn't get a goal his first seven games.
Five hole between the legs. Okay, it was tipped. It was tipped by one of the Avalanche players. Because it looked like from our side, we're on the other side, that Waugh saw it the whole way. But the defenseman just got his stick on it enough to game. And again, when he looks so solid in net. When he is playing well. You saw the shot being lined up at the point. You saw how big Waugh can seemingly make himself. He's already made two breakaway saves.
Here comes Sackett now. In with Kaminsky. Sackett. The drive and Salo! What a save with his blocker on that patented snapshot from Joe Sackett. 9:10 to go.
Great play there by Lemieux. You saw Kaminsky get the puck. The minute Kaminsky got the puck, watch on the right side of your screen. Kaminsky pulls away, and Lemieux, I mean, he put his head down and just worked as hard as he could to get himself open to take the pass. And he's lazy getting the open. Had his head down for just a second, and oh! That is a hit.
And a legal hit. And Cash Bright has played with that.
Keep it in. And the Islanders break away. And here's a break for Quad. In the clear. Hit the goal post. Quad hit the right goal post. That's the third breakaway tonight for New York. And they haven't scored on any of them. Forsberg now. 5 seconds left in the power kick. This team leading 3-1.
Has to give somebody a little more ice time on the left wing. And a better choice in tonight's game than Kaminsky, who has been from the opening faceoff just fine for Colorado. Right there, nice save again by Salo. When this guy cranks it up, the speed goes to the outside.
Now Pilon for New York gives it up and Forsberg dashes back in the zone. Great pass. Being upset. You get four guys around him.
the new innovations they had with the blue dot and the comet behind the puck when the puck was shot over 70 miles an hour. And, you know, and it was a perfect place to start it. The players. This year was interesting. It was a $250,000 pot.
Eric Lindros and the Flyers visited the Rangers in their massive 21.
I want
warming. A great shot by Palfy. He's been raw on two breakaways. Right here, he just takes his time, and Patrick Waugh going down, up over the far shoulder. John, you talk about a momentum switch in this hockey game for the New York Islanders.
Gets it out. Avalanche lead by one now. Forsberg beats him in. Now right in. Save it, and they score! I think it is an Islander, and it's 4-2.
Well, what a great move by Forsberg. But John, watch the stick of Claude Lemieux. Left side. See if it's the Islander defenseman or Lemieux's stick. Touches the puck.
I think it hit the skate of McKinnis.
Here we'll get a good look at it right here. Yep, exactly. The skate of McKinnis. He and Lemieux tied up. Forsberg gets a goal to give this game back to the lead for the Islanders, for the Avalanche.
There's Simon now. Muscles in front. Can't get a shot. 4-3.
Well, Mark Crawford's like the fact that his Avalanche have come back and gotten big goals after Islander goals. Milbury's got to be impressed.
Snyder stole it. Sackett trying to get it back. Played ahead by Snyder. Goes Lynch on the line. Now Sackett again. Cuts it in. 4-4 Bird. Lemieux in the slot.
Lemieux has gone to a new stick for tonight's game. It's one of the metal sticks. And he has snapped off a couple of great shots. And right there, he used the screen. He did everything perfectly. Salo just robbed him.
That was the save of the night. He has been tremendous. His first start since early November.
And the first 5 minutes, John, I think both you and I are saying, boy, this kid.
Now, this game should be over.